I write this diary giving thanks to the mountains and to the flowing waters. My headaches continue today. That bruise seems to have gotten bigger, too. Should I see a doctor?
A bruise? What is she referring to? That's right. She was still alive when she got that bruise on her hand.
I write this diary giving thanks to the mountains and to the flowing waters. A miracle happened today. I can barely believe it. I heard God's voice, beautiful and pure. The bruise on my hand is a sigil passed on to me by God Himself.
I see. Well, I'm no theologian, but I doubt this was a revelation from God. What happened to her was caused by... Right. Her experience was likely caused by the tumor in her prefrontal lobe. She interpreted the whispers of her disease as the voice of the Creator.
I write this diary giving thanks to the mountains and to the flowing waters. Today I heard a shocking premonition. We were walking the path against God's divine will. My pain was inflicted on me as a punishment and a warning to me and my family. I cannot let this be. I must save my family. I write this diary, giving thanks to the mountains and to the flowing waters. The preparations have been made. I will become the beast of the Lord and lead my loving family. I will sever them from this world and engrave the sigil upon their bodies too. Abby, my little girl, I willingly become the beast so I can save you.
Beast of the Lord. That explains the fur.
I write this diary, giving thanks to the mountains and to the flowing waters. I learned a terrible truth today. My little Abby never reached his side. It's my fault. I severed her connection before engraving the sigil. Ah, my loving daughter, please forgive your mother for being so foolish. Joseph will be saved. I will engrave his sigil and lead his soul. I'll make sure it won't hurt. Joseph, let us be reunited in his world.
The diary ends here. Alma died after writing this. The sigil that she says she engraved onto her daughter is... That's right. Alma thought the black bruise on her hand appeared as a holy sign. That's why she thought she was saving her daughter's soul using the same pattern. She also planned to do the same to her husband. When she said she'd make sure it won't hurt, she meant... Indeed. This diary answers a number of the questions we've had regarding this case. Until this point, I had thought that Alma and Abigail had been killed by the same person. But now it's clear who killed Abigail. And yet, there are several things found at the crime scene that could not have been Alma's doing. I need to review the information we have to determine if these murders were committed by the same person. Hey, little guy. I have something else that I need you to analyze for me.
You do? I thought we've already been through everything.
It's more that I want you to sort through what we know. Alma wore the mask and the fur when she killed Abigail. However, Alma couldn't have done everything herself. For example... Yes, Alma didn't stab herself, and there were obvious attempts to hide evidence after Alma's death. One such piece of evidence is... Yes, someone tried to destroy the costume Alma wore in the fireplace. Another piece is... Indeed. The weapon Alma is believed to have used was hidden inside the clock.
Only one person was able to do this.
Yes. Now we can finally see everything that happened in this case.